Sorry for getting this call out in the morning. But hi there everyone, welcome back to another video of Late Late Customs. Make sure Shin is actually getting out there. Hi there everyone, welcome back to another video of Late Late Customs. Today we are simply drifting away. Slowly drifting away. Anyway guys, we are currently on our way to Walmart. And if you guys are not familiar with Walmart, he's actually the founder of these spray paintings. So we're heading out to Walmart real quick because he's actually in the process with the three stage on my P20. So we're gonna go there and actually do some filming. Hopefully we'll have the car done by tomorrow. Few problems came up. I think he said he's gonna touch up the fender as well as the spoiler. So we'll just have to find out about that. I'm not entirely sure what's actually going on there, but I'm gonna go there. Sorry guys. Actually I have the camera here by my cluster. And unfortunately I have to go sideways over the speed bumps. This is actually the best location for a camera. Like, I'm actually impressed with myself with this because we usually put our phones here. Besides the point guys, we are heading out to Walmart and we're gonna do some filming on the B20. Super excited for the car. Hopefully we'll have the car back by tomorrow. Tomorrow is Friday. And like I just promised you guys in all of my previous videos, we are gonna get the YT content back soon, because I know many of you guys have been requesting some yellow thing content, and I am bringing yellow thing content back once the B20 is fully assembled and kind of like done with everything I have. So I think it will be in this video which I'll break you guys through everything we actually have for the car. But stay tuned and hope you guys enjoyed this video, and don't forget to smash the like button. Do subscribe to the channel because the content from here is just getting even more exciting. The reason why actually I haven't been filming the past 2 weeks that much is because, well, there hasn't really been that much exciting content, and you guys have been fed up with wire tucks. And on the other thing, we actually have to continue with the wire tuck. So I'm actually, well, improvising my strategy with video taking and the content. So hope you guys understand that. But let's get started with today's video. You guys probably haven't heard this car drive in quite some time, and this car is actually quite low. Like, I'm talking about from the branch to the ground, because that's the reason why I have to go sideways. But for some reason I still have the earth noise in the car. I have no idea where it's coming from. So if any of you guys can maybe assist me on that, I've tried multiple methods trying to solve the problem, but unfortunately still can't solve the problem. But we're pulling up here to Wilma's house now, and we're gonna have a lovely day. Well, you can actually hear, he's actually busy buffing already. Just got here to Wilma's house, so we have to get a mask on, because you know COVID and so. But I can actually hear him polishing the car already. Oh, here's the man outside already. Oh, wait, wait. finally taking home, lads. We finally taking home. Sheesh. This camera doesn't want to focus at all. So Wilma will have to drive in front of me because unfortunately this is actually extremely illegal, so I wouldn't advise doing this. So yeah. It's on, yeah, the spotlights are on. So you will have to drive in front of me. So yeah. Yeah, brother, the branch is pretty low. I told Wilma just be very cautious with the car because the branch is extremely low. This is actually a few days later, and I haven't been shooting any videos on this car ever since. They had some problems with the fenders and the bumpers because the colors didn't match due to using a different branded wap paint. But that's all about everything. The car is currently only like one stage, so they still need to do stage 2, which is the polish, and stage 3, which is the wax, is the finish of the car. But I will be doing all the simple work, so it means more content for you guys. And I will break you guys through all the mods I have planned for this car, because I literally have most of the stuff in the car. There was an incident earlier where I thought the car hit a blown heat gasket, or actually I thought it blown its heat gasket. So I removed the valve cover cap and it was a bit moisture. So it's usually sometimes when your car sits too much and all that, like, because it's cold weather, it builds up to your cap. But I drove the car now, the oil seems fine, everything seems good, there's no problems on the car. So I will need to just to double check the car after everything is done, drive the car again, just make sure everything is fine. But Tana Holloway did explain to me it usually happens on these cars as well as the Polo, so I don't really need to worry. But I know you guys are extremely excited for this car. I know, well, a few of you guys are excited and many of you guys are excited for this car, but I promised you guys that once this car is up and running as my daily, and I got most of the stuff sorted, which will most probably be in the next 2 weeks to a month, this car will be completed real, real soon once I'm done with this car. So once this car is done, there's no content planned for this car and for the VTEC standing right there. So it will be solely focused just on the yellow thing, getting everything started. And I'll break you guys through the few problems I actually have for this car, but you are just prayed on that one, problems. But the car came out amazing. I'm gonna give the car clean tomorrow and I'll break you guys through everything we have planned for this car and a future well, vision for this car as well. And do comment down below what you guys would like to see done on this car. But I'll pick up this camera again tomorrow because well, we are gonna celebrate Tegan's birthday tonight as well. So kind of my like bachelor's thingamajiggy. It's not really my party, but I think I also deserve a celebration for my achievements. And that's the reason why I haven't really uploaded, because I know this is like mid section of the video, but the main reason why I haven't really uploaded much videos is because, well, I don't really want to bore you guys out with content. I've realized that many of you guys are always complaining in the comment section below that we're doing the same stuff the whole time. So I'm just trying to get my planning in order, and then hopefully from the start of September we can continue with our upload streak, our regular upload schedule. So I'll pick up this camera again tomorrow, which is going to be Sunday. Won't do a lot of filming tomorrow, but I'll break you guys through everything about this car and just clean it up and show you guys everything or the state it's currently in. So I'll see you guys tomorrow. A few days later and we are currently back. Yesterday I actually took some time off and worked on the car. But what I managed to do in the car is just assemble the complete interior, because it's quite a long and boring process, to be honest. So I'm gonna take you guys through the car quick. Here you guys can currently see we have all the beadings on, we have the fresh headlights in, which I did not tell you guys about at all. Woo. These headlights are looking sweet. So we got the headlights in, and one thing or another thing I didn't tell you guys about, I got my hands on a seat of semi-cleas. So semi-cleas is on. I fitted the spoiler last night. There are two bulbs in the rear tail lights that do not work with the brake lights, so I'll need to get that sorted. But besides that, the car is not done yet, guys. So if you guys can see, there's a lot of overspray. And the reason why I took the car is because I need to fully assemble the car, then DSD spray painting will go through the entire car, clean up all these rough edges, guys can see right here, and give the car a nice 3-stage polish because the car is currently just compound. But we definitely still need to do a lot more stuff to this car right here. I'm extremely happy because last night we managed to get a lot done, which were the lights, the interior, the boot spoiler, the beadings on the sides. We got the patch installed here on the rear, which you guys can see right there. And the car is looking very, very nice. We actually got a nice radio here in the car as well. Just check out here. Let me just switch it on for you guys. Guys, you can see I bought me a nice secondhand JVC radio, as you guys can see right there. You guys can see. And one thing I think, like, a lot of you guys won't be really keen for. Let me just put this radio off here real quick. But let me just do this. One thing you guys won't be keen for, which you guys most probably, don't really appreciate me doing. But I just felt I'm gonna do it because I'm gonna see it a lot. And because it actually seized up. But like a few days before the car went off the spray painter, the cluster actually seized up on 299,000 kilometers. Like while it was hitting over to 299,000 kilometers, the cluster actually seized up. So everything was working except like showing here the reading at the bottom and obviously the kilometer reading. So what I did, I opened up the cluster and realized that one of the pins actually popped out. I'll link a video in the description down below of like the person like fixing that. So I didn't really film or do much filming regarding that, but I actually turned down the cluster to 205,000 just for my personal taste. Obviously me making this video is actually me explaining myself, so I don't think that's something I really want to hide. And the main reason also why I turned it back is because it's not the original engine in the car anymore. So what's the point then? This is not the kilometers of the car. The car's kilometers is actually 299,000. So yeah, I just thought I'll share that with you guys. So in case you're thinking I'm hiding it away, but I think it's actually very, very attractive to look at 205 kilometers, because I asked in the group and everybody said, look, you turn it around to 205. So I'm very, very happy with that. And please do not follow this method when you're gonna sell your car, because that's, well, truth worthy, I think. So yeah, don't do that. You loop your mains in, so. But car's looking really nice. There's actually one light dead here, so you guys can see that. Just I need to replace this bulb. I want to put some nice LED bulbs in this cluster as well, so I'll definitely share that with you guys in the future. We have some nice cup holders here. It's very dark, because guys, it's very dark, you guys can't really see, but this battery is actually quite flat though, to be honest. So I don't think it's actually gonna start now. I don't think it's gonna start. Ah, it actually started. So you guys haven't actually heard this car start at all in a while. Yeah, sounding nice. Woo. I'm super, super excited for this car, guys. Once again, thanks to each and everyone for understanding why I actually took a break for the past week or two. I just needed to get up on my feet again. But I know you guys are requesting Yellow Thing content. You guys are like always commenting. What about the Yellow Thing? We will start working on the car real soon. It's just like the problem is, I think it's like you're not really that much excited anymore for the car. So I just need to like get into the feels for it again. But at the time, my dad's using my Honda, so I don't have a daily, and that was the main goal. I need to fix up this car at the time just to get it up and running. And one thing you guys don't even know is that I got like a few mods for the car. It's nothing to be extremely excited about. Basically nice entry mods you can do to a car and like, well, just enjoy the car. So yeah, I will be continuing the video today, but it will be in the next video of me actually doing a few other mods for the car and getting it ready for Walmart. So I'm still waiting on a few parts to actually come in and a few stuff to come in order to finish off the car, as well as to fit the front bumper, because you guys know I actually did a flush on the front bumper. But I'll see you guys in the next video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you guys did, don't forget to smash that like button. Do subscribe to the channel, because this is gonna be like the ultimate daily. B20 ultimate daily. Clutch that slipping, but they will be all solved in the future. So I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out.